Fred Couples, birdie putt at 13. And that gets Fred to 4 under. Fred birdied the first 3 holes of the day. Fred Couples, a 2-time winner of the Hoag Classic. Fred Couples for birdie at 14.
Could be quick at the very end, going down the slope. Oh, great try by Fred.
Fred Couples, his second into 15.
Just an iron in here for Fred. Boy, I'd look for this to get close. This is right up his alley. Oh, comes up short left, probably.
Couples third at 15.
Normally an excellent bunker player. Didn't quite grab for him. I thought it might pull up a little quicker, but still 6 feet or less for Fred. Good shot.
Couples for his birdie at 15.
Pulled it the whole way. Not one of his better strokes. That's disappointing, having an iron to the par five and walking off with par.
Back of the Hoag Classic, Fred Couples second into 16.
Huge tee shot for Fred. Great look here. Good chance to stick one close. Oh, he's hole high right.
Fred Couples for his birdie at 16.
Left-hand low from about 20 feet. He usually doesn't go that method unless he's a little closer.
Back of the Hoag Classic. Fred Couples on the tee at 17. Tracer Technology presented by TrackMan will follow the tee shot of Fred.
Hole location right over the bunker in the center of the green right there. See if Fred likes to milk it a little bit left to right. I wouldn't be surprised if this doesn't start on the left edge of that back bunker and maybe fall a little right.
Looks like that wind picked up a little bit at 17 as he backed off.
If he plays that shot, that would be using the slope of the green to have the ball work to the hole. And left to the left edge of the bunker, falling a little bit right. Right over top of the flag. What a great shot.
Couples for his birdie at 17.
Saw the putt right in front of him from Davis, just outside the right edge. Can he hit it hard enough? He never got it high enough, nor hard enough. Not a good putt there by Fred.
A par for Couples. See the fast start, one birdie since the third hole. Fred Couples on the tee at 18.
Uh-oh, doesn't like it. Bunker's rim play. Needs to get lucky. Oh, it did. It hit soft, stayed just left of him.
Now let's go back over to 18 and Fred Couples to play his second. Fred lives here in Newport Beach, California.
It's a big hit here for Fred, but I think he can get it there. Always been an excellent three-wood player. Maybe a hair right. Might catch a piece of it. Just off the right front. Pretty simple look there. Just a straight pitch and run right up the slope for Fred from there.
Back here at the Hoag Classic, Fred Couples surveying his third shot here at 18. What kind of shot do you think he'll play here, Lanny?
You know, Fred, he's got so many shots. He looks like he's got a wedge of some sort. I don't think it's a 60. Probably a 50 or 56 back in his stance, little pitch and run. I wouldn't think he would carry it up around the hole. Anything from here, he's in the fairway. You have as good a lie as he wants with all this green to work with. Old school way is to go. I'm sitting here thinking if I was hitting this, it'd probably be 8 or 9 iron, carry it onto the green, get it rolling like a putt. Fred tends to put it back in the stance and hit that kind of shot, but with more loft. That's the danger right there of hitting it with a wedge. If you don't rip it, it just doesn't have the go, doesn't have the chase out.
Wound up making par at 15 and has this left for birdie here at 18.
Yeah, he's not as long as he once was in his prime, Bob, but he's still plenty long for this tour. And when you put together the length he has with a 3-wood, more than enough to reach almost every par 5. That was a beautiful stroke right there. That putter head released very nicely. Good read. Nice round by Fred Couples.
Fred Couples second at the ninth.
Oh, caged up the right-hand side of the green. Freddy usually likes that. Yes, he does. Takes dead aim. Beautiful shot. And here by Couples.
Fred Couples, another good look at birdie. He's had a lot of good opportunities today.
He's got to move a little right. Stays right there.
And Fred Couples from off the green for birdie with putter. Second shot for Fred Couples at the par 4 11th.
Full location left. And should spin, it does. Great shot by Fred. Just a tap-in birdie from about a foot.
Couples, one of three men to have won this event twice. He, Jay Haas, and Hale Irwin in the rich tradition of the Hoag Classic. Time now for a classic moment presented by Konica Minolta at the 2014 Hoag Classic. Fred Couples found himself in a battle with fellow competitors Colin Montgomery, Bernhard Langer, and Steve Pate. Couples sank this 4-foot birdie at 17. It left him tied with the three others going to the final hole. After hitting his approach over the green at 18, Couples had to scramble to give himself this birdie putt and a chance to win. The 4-footer dropped, giving Couples a one-shot victory in his second Hoag Classic win. And that's your classic moment. Fred Couples saw that nifty shot into 11. Makes the birdie. Couples, third birdie of the day, no bogeys. He's within one of the lead with a couple par fives still to come.
$15 a bag. That's pretty high. I was getting three, and a good day, I'd probably get three and maybe a dollar tip, so $8.
Look at this shot by Couples at the 12th. Great showman. Couples for his birdie at 12.
Needs this one. Yeah. Oh, wow. Power lip out on the high side.
Be honest with you, I didn't see that much break.
Fred Couples tee shot at 13. Fred missed a short birdie putt at 12.
Full location, kind of back left center. Oh, that. Ooh, I thought one more hop, it might get close. Hit a little soft on him. Still a good shot there by Fred.
Enjoying his time out here. Now Fred Couples for birdie.
High point just left to Fred. This should fall a little left to right for him going up there. Puts it out there. Will it move? Ooh, it moved more than he thought. Pretty good try. Fred's hit some good putts that have not gone down. Quality shots hole after hole. You kind of feel like he's going to get on a heater here at some point in time, Bob, but maybe with the par fives finishing up 15 and 18.
Second for Fred Couples at 14.
Another right hole location. Fred likes those. He likes to hit a little drop cut. He can usually get these things close. Did I say he can usually get those close? He does. Beautiful shot by Fred. He's hit a lot of quality shots. Another guy hitting a lot of quality shots. Fred Couples, and he gets that to go down to put him at 9-under. Fred making it look easy today. Really, he's 4-under.
Fred Couples, third at 15.
Par five, Freddie normally a beautiful bunker player. Gets away from him a little bit. He's not going to be happy with that one.
Now Couples for his birdie at 15. Birdie 15 yesterday.
Yeah, longer look than he was hoping for here, but no problem for Fred. Finally, the putter woke up.
That's the 38th birdie at 15 today. And Fred Couples now at 10-under and has a one-shot lead. No one has won this tournament more than twice. Fred Couples on the tee at 16.
Bunker's down the left-hand side. Plenty of room down the right. Freddie normally a wonderful driver of the golf ball.
Yeah, I liked it on the tee.
Swing, Freddie.
And they're going to like it now. It's right down the center, way past those bunkers. Good strike there by Fred. Not surprising.
Over to 16. Fred Couples second on its way.
Ooh, good shot there by Fred on a very difficult hole. Great tee shot. Set that up. Man, he likes these right hole locations. Pretty straight look here for Fred. Not a lot in this. No pace issues. Oh, he got it left and it stayed there. A little quicker at the end than I thought.
Fred Couples on the tee at 17.
Yeah, 17 playing 177 a day downhill. Hole location right in that front left. Freddie's iron game has been really dialed in today, Bob.
Lanny, with his ball flight, you know, you talked about those right hole locations. Even though where it is, kind of the angle, he can kind of just feed it off right the front left part of the green and let it feed in.
Yes, this green really slopes down to the right, goes right to left down here all the way across the green. So if Fred can just keep it up in the left center of the green, just left of the hole, he should be fine. And he did. Should get back. Oh, it didn't get back on the edge, but that's a legitimate birdie look from right there.
Had a good look at 16. It didn't fall.
Might be a little quick. Got to watch the pace here a little bit. Oh, did he hit it? Being careful with it. Understandable.
Couples will have that to remain at 10 under, one back of Doug Barron. Alfred Couples on the tee at 18.
Plenty wide fairway for Fred. He's got a lot of length still.
Shot.
He really drives it really, really straight for a guy. Hits it as far as he always has. Doesn't have the pop he used.
Right, Couples getting set to play a second into 18.
And he can get there. He's got the firepower.
There have been no eagles at 18
today. Hole location over on the right-hand side. Don't want to go too far right, and he's left. Not his best strike there, Bob.
Fred Couples to play his third at 18.
Yeah, the only thing positive for here for Fred is he's got a lot of green to work with. Tugged the second. Tough little hole location sitting over on that right front. Kind of played a little mini flop. Carried it further than he meant to. No question.
So your upper left, Fred Couples, has this for birdie at 18 to get to 11 under and within a shot of the lead.
And he never gets it high enough.
Missed the green earlier. Fred Couples all pars through his opening six. This for birdie at seven.
Ooh, good looking putt. Just quit breaking.
Couples is the only player in the field that's bogey free this week. Fred, a two-time winner of the Hoag Classic. Fred Couples on the tee at the eighth. And landing today 188 yards.
Yeah, really good par three. Green sits a little awkward, kind of slopes left to right. It's not the most comfortable shot in the world. You're up above it hitting down, and the target looks a little on the small side.
33 players have played the eighth hole today, and it's playing as the hardest hole on the golf course, a third of a shot over par. There have been no birdies at the eighth today. Couples a winner here in 2010 and 2014.
He hit some great irons yesterday to right hole locations. This one's up the right side of the green. Let's see if he can get it. That one's going a little bit left. It is. It's just short of hole high. Got a long putt, probably 45 feet for birdie.
Long birdie putt for Fred Couples at the eighth.
That's well done. Very, very well done. Great pace coming down that slope. Another one he's going to have to hammer.
couple second at the ninth.
One hands, it means it's probably not, doesn't like it a lot, but it worked out okay. It's back to the hole and a decent look for Fred.
Over at the ninth, Fred Couples looking for his first birdie of the day.
Can he get something going? Yes, Fred.
So Couples gets to within one. Only the third birdie of the day at the ninth. Fred Couples coming off his first birdie of the day on the tee at the 10th.
Good driving hole here at 10, but Fred has been driving the ball exceptionally well. Got bunkers down the right-hand side you really don't want to mess with. And that's well left for Fred. He didn't mess with him. He's
Fred Couples getting set to play his second. Charles Schwab Cup total purse payout. First earns you $1 million. Second place, $500,000. He's got caddy Joe LaCava walking all the way up to the green here at 10.
I got to tell you, I don't think I've seen Fred hit a ball this far offline in a long time. He's been driving it on a string all week, solid, straight, long. This one came out of the wrong barrel.
But it was so far left, Lanny, that
he's wide open. Yeah. And actually has a good angle at the flag, Bob.
Good to see Joe back out here after taking a little time off. Tiger with some time off, so Joe was in Tucson and
Fred's over there by
working.
Fred's over by one of the corporate tents. He could stop in for a little refreshment if he'd like. Maybe Joe will.
136. Now a couple second at the 10th.
Like a pretty clean strike. Oh, too clean, right over the back of the green. Wow.
Third shot for Couples at 10.
Yeah, no bogey so far this week. Need to get this one close. Got a little work left. That's good 6-7 feet.
Fred Couples at the Hoag Classic. Share the lead. This for par at the 10th.
Ooh, not even close.
That's his first bogey of the week. Fred Couples on the tee at the 11th, coming off his first bogey of the week.
Cool tee shot at 10. Let's see if he straightens it out here at 11. He does, right down the gut. Beautiful tee shot. Just a little wedge left into this short par four for club.
Couples second at 11.
Big tee shot. Can he get a bounce forward? Not enough. Well, we've seen a whole bunch of balls end up right there on this hole today.
Couples for his birdie at the 11th.
See if he can get it high enough. The last two we've seen have not been. Oh, needed more pace. That was a good read.
Second for Fred Couples at 12.
Laid up short of the bunkers, and boy, he has a great look at this flag. Can he dial one in? A little deep. Big first hop there. Yeah, now Freddy, about 25 feet. Tough read here, kind of coming over his shoulder of the green.
Fred Couples for his par at the 12th.
Ooh.
So Couples went 45 holes without a bogey and has now made two of them over his last three holes. Fred Couples has bogeyed two of his last three holes after going 45 holes bogey free. Now finds himself three off the lead. Tee shot at 13.
Trying to hit a little drop fade and turned it over the other way. Not what he was looking for there.
In Couples' long birdie putt. Fred two over his last three.
Yeah, good 45 feet here for Fred. Oh, my.
Wow. Over at 14, Fred Couples is having a blah kind of day. Birdie the ninth, bogey 10 and 12. Had that birdie putt hang on the edge of the hole at 13, and that takes a big bounce off the back of the green at 14. Still muttering about that. Over at 14, third for Couples. Couple still away for par. And that gets rejected. Boy, Lanny, this might be one of the big shocks in the fact that Fred's won here twice, didn't make a bogey through his first 45, makes birdie at 9 and 3 over here on the second 9. Third shot for Fred Couples at 15. Mentioned 16. Couples has this for par. So he stays at 9 under.